Overtraining, Wikipedia article audio. Overtraining is the result of giving your body more work or stress than it can handle. Overtraining occurs when a person experiences stress and physical trauma from exercising faster than their body can repair the damage. Overtraining can be described as a point where a person may have a decrease in performance and plateauing as a result of failure to consistently perform at a certain level or training load, a load which exceeds their recovery capacity. People who are overtrained cease making progress, and can even begin to lose strength and fitness. Overtraining is also known as chronic fatigue, burnout, and overstress in athletes. It is suggested that there are different variations of overtraining. Firstly, monotonous program overtraining suggests that repetition of the same movements such as certain weight lifting and baseball batting can cause performance plateau due to an adaptation of the central nervous system which results from a lack of stimulation. A second example of overtraining is described as chronic overwork type training, where the subject may be training with too high intensity or high volume and not allowing sufficient recovery time for the body. Up to 10% of elite endurance athletes and 10% of American college swimmers are affected by overtraining syndrome. Signs and symptoms. Performance. Cause. Mechanism. Treatment. Diet. Prevention. Listed below are some of the common effects and cited signs of overtraining. Overtraining may be accompanied by one or more concomitant symptoms. It is important to note the difference between overtraining and overreaching. Overreaching is when an athlete is undergoing hard training but with adequate recovery. Overtraining, however, is when an athlete is undergoing hard training without the adequate recovery. With overreaching, the consequential drop in performance can be resolved in a few days or weeks. It is also important to remember that the effect of overtraining is not isolated only to affecting the athlete's athletic ability, but it can have implications on other areas of life such as performance in studies or the workforce. An overtrained athlete who is suffering from physical and/or psychological symptoms could also have trouble socializing with friends and family, studying for an exam, or prepping for work. Like pharmacological drugs, physical exercise may be chemically addictive. Addiction can be defined as the frequent engaging in the behavior to a greater extent or for a longer time period than intended. It is theorized that this addiction is due to natural endorphins and dopamine generated and regulated by the exercise. Whether strictly due to this chemical byproduct or not, some people can be said to become addicted to or fixated on psychological/physical effects of physical exercise and fitness. This may lead to overexercise, resulting in the overtraining syndrome. A number of possible mechanisms for overtraining have been proposed. Allowing more time for the body to recover. Seeing as there are many non-beneficial results of overtraining and the main treatment is taking time out to rest, so to avoid taking time off, training prevention is very important for many athletes. An additional method preferred by many collegiate and professional level athletes is the incorporation of active recovery into training. The gradual varying of intensity and volume of training is an effective way to prevent overtraining. The athlete should be closely monitored by keeping records of weight, diet, and heart rate, and the training program should be adjusted in accordance to different physical and emotional stresses. Along with the recording of rest, diet, weight, and heart rates, there are multiple training types that can assist with ensuring that overtraining is not occurring. Interval training ensures that, even though they are short, rest periods during training are taken. The periods of high intensity and low intensity mixed characteristics of interval training enable athletes to ensure they are including rest and allowing the body to rest or repair in between intervals and in between each stage of a training session. Australian rowers require a mix of technique, power, and endurance of both the aerobic and anaerobic energy systems. Follow a strict training schedule to enable them to ensure that rest is taken into account to ensure that overtraining is not present. Train upwards of 11 months of the year. This large volume of training is well spaced and thought out to avoid overtraining symptoms. Persistent muscle soreness. Persistent fatigue. This is different from just being tired from a hard training session. This occurs when fatigue continues even after adequate rest, elevated resting heart rate, a persistently high heart rate after adequate rest, such as in the morning after sleep. This can be an indicator of overtraining, reduced heart rate variability, increased susceptibility to infections, increased incidence of injuries, irritability, depression, mental breakdown, burnout. Microtrauma to the muscles are created faster than the body can heal them. Amino acids are used up faster than they are supplied in the diet. This is sometimes called protein deficiency. Systemic inflammation, which results in the release of cytokines activating an immune response. Taking a break from training to allow time for recovery, reducing the volume and/or the intensity of the training, suitable periodization of training, splitting the training program so that different sets of muscles are worked on different days, increased sleep time, deep tissue or sports massage of the affected muscles, self-massage or rub down of the affected muscles. Short sprints with long resting time once the athlete is able to continue with light training.